What is up guys, Klaus here, and today we're gonna be looking at our top picks for swordsmen in One Piece anime. Let's begin. At number 10 spot on our list, we have Kyrus. Although he has nothing special going for him, apart from his unbendable will of course, he is a very skilled fighter indeed. He possesses an incredible agility and strength, which allowed him to achieve 3000 victories at Elysium and become a living legend. He beheads Doffy, and we get the most surprised face in this series. Being heavily outmatched, he defeats current hero of the Coliseum, Diamante, who is one of the top 3 officers of Doflamingo's family. He was believed to be strong enough to handle all winners, including Barges and Lucy, in the final fight for the Devil Fruit, but he proved to be no match for Kyrus, who cuts through his steel sword and brings him down. The 9th place on our top takes Kinemon. Coming from Wano County, he proves that they don't call it Samurai Land for nothing. He can ignite enemies with his swords, and much to Zoro's surprise, he can even cut through the fire itself. Steel is also not a problem for this guy, as he states that's easy and slices through the thick sanctuary door. Of course his good flying snake will cause him no trouble, and once again we can see fire coming out of thin air. But since he had no major fight so far, we will leave him here for now. Our 8th place we give to the most attractive guy out there, Cavendish. But don't make his looks delude you, he has a dark side. And boy it's strong! His alter ego guy is arguably the fastest man in the world. He is so fast that he creates a dust cloud and momentarily defeats a whole block of fighters. You may have fancy heels, teeth and horns, but I don't laugh when this guy is around. Although Dillinger is also notorious for his speed, he didn't even see what hit him. With his eyes full of astonishment, he passes out and sees a pair of good sneakers in his dream. Number 7. Roronoa Zoro. Yeah, now we're talking. This wannabe world's greatest swordsman is a no-brainer pick for a top 10 list. He may not be best now, but he's definitely on his way to it. He surely has an amazing potential. For an instance, in his fight with Steel Body Mr. One, on the brink of his death, he learned to cut steel and slice dust bones with his having been taught by Mihawk himself, further improved his abilities and granted him this mysterious closed eye. No wonder that he easily overpowered Pika and chopped his gigantic statue into pieces. Down at the 6th level sits Shiryu. Now, we don't know much about his sword skills, so all of our assumptions are made around the statement that he is equal to Magellan in combat, and since his main and only weapon is katana, it means that he is so good with it that they call him equal to one of the strongest characters in One Piece. Even combined forces of Luffy, Crocodile, Mr. 1, 2 and 3, Jinbei and Ivankov himself with lots of other prisoners couldn't even scratch this poisonous beast. If someone calls you equal to this monster, that should mean something. At the 5th place resides Dark King Rayleigh. He is easily one of the strongest characters in One Piece, but we don't know if it's so due to his sword skills. All we ever could see is that he fought Admiral Kizaru equally using his sword, which is the first time he used it in many years. Rayleigh is proficient in all types of haki and has ridiculous strength and stamina. He managed to swim his way through one ocean to another just like that. I hope we'll see more action from him in the future. Flowerblade Vista. Despite having only one instance with him, we can see that he is equal to Mihawk in battle. Mihawk is well aware of him, saying like, "How can I not know you?" His signature move is some rose leaves attack, but rumors say that he can produce any flower. We don't know how powerful this attack is, but we can see that Mihawk smells something bad and uses his two-hand swing to send a powerful green wave that pierces through flowers with ease. But Vista has no trouble deflecting this wave. They promise each other to continue their battle later. Before we jump to our top 3 picks, here are some honorable mentions. Mont Blanc Noland. I think you can put this guy in any top. He has so many different traits and skills to offer, and one of them is his sword mastery. Being unnaturally strong, he was able to deliver powerful strikes, and he decapitates this giant snake which has such a tough skin that Zoro and Viper could do nothing to it. We'll talk more about this character in our future videos. A mention also deserves Lion Shiki. He was one of the strongest pirates of his time, on par with Gold D. Roger and Whitebeard himself. Wielding a katana in each hand, he killed dozens of marines, and it took Sengoku and goddamn Gap to bring him down. After losing his legs, now he used his swords in their place. But it doesn't seem to affect his sword skills at all. He says to Straw Hats that they aren't even worth killing. If it wasn't for that storm that saved Goldie Roger's ass, we might not have even got to see a Pirate King. And the bronze medal on this list belongs to Shanks. When he still had both of his hands present, he was rivaling Mihawk in swordsmanship. But when he lost his arm to a Sea King, Mihawk lost his interest in fighting him. But it looks like having no arm doesn't bother him at all. He crossed his swords with Whitebeard, fights Skyler behind the scenes, and stops a war by threatening Marines. Well, overall, the Yonko title allows Shanks to steal 3rd place from Vista's pocket. Here we are, the silver plate goes to the world's greatest swordsman Mihawk. We've been referencing him in most of our ranks, and now it's time to give credits where credit is due. Mihawk was a rookie when Goldie Roger was executed, and somewhere along the line, after Shanks lost his arm, Mihawk acquired his supreme title. We've seen on numerous occasions that his abilities are unmatched, and it looks like there's nothing that he can't cut. Also, he states that he has the strongest sword in the world. And I know what all of you guys have on your minds right now. If Mihawk is second, who the fuck is number one then? And the winner is Ryuma. Yes, you heard it right. Cause this guy is the strongest swordsman in this series. Many of you may know him as Zombie Ryuma, but Zombie just had slightly above Brook's level of skill. The actual Ryuma is a samurai from Wano country, and he is considered a legend there. To dig more into this character, we'll have to take one of Oda's early manga's monsters. It is also canon in One Piece. In this manga, Ryuma is looking for a strong samurai that people call King in order to fight him, but ironically, he is the said King. This name was given to him by people. The story in this manga is short. All we have is a first-rate swordsman Sairanu and a huge dragon. You can also notice a lot of similarities between Zoro and Ryuma, and oddly enough, Sairanu somewhat resembles Mihawk. There's a real cool theory about Zoro being Ryuma's descendant. I'll leave the link in the description, so definitely check it out. So Ryuma kills Sairanu with a single strike, showing how much stronger he is, and then dragon flies in. Now that's what you call dragon, not that cute pussy Pank Hazard one. Just look at his fangs, Jesus Christ, this thing is terrifying. And it's not just some dragon, it requires a special horn to summon. And guess what? Ryuma kills it with a single strike as well. So the point here is not that he easily kills a dragon, but that he had no hesitation in doing it. Although he has never seen this creature, he knew for sure that it won't be any problem for him. Ryuma was the strongest samurai of his time, just like Mihawk is the strongest one right now. But Ryuma has more background, and he's a legend after all. Well, that is it guys, thank you very much for watching, we hope you liked this video, throw down a like if you did, and subscribe if you want to see more in the future, and we'll see you next time.